Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I want to talk to you a little bit about weight loss today. And if you're new here, welcome. I'm glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knudsen. I'm a certified holistic health coach and the creator of the 90-day Walk the Fibroid Freedom Group coaching program, where I help women to shrink fibroids naturally using food as medicine. There's a link down in the description box where you can learn more about that if you're interested. Also, be sure to subscribe to this channel, hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode if you like what you see. All right, today I want to talk to you a little bit about my own weight loss journey. I started this YouTube channel about, 2007, I started making videos on YouTube in 2008, and it was really about food and weight loss. That's what the channel was about. Most of my videos that I have made over the years are still on my channel. I have made some of them private, some of them that are irrelevant to what I'm doing these days are private, but you can go back on my channel and see a lot of information about like my weight loss journey. And so whenever I really first started losing weight, I was well into probably the 220s, almost 230. I know that I the last time I stepped on the scale when I was in the high the low 200s is 217 pounds. And I said I was never going to get on the scale anymore because I just didn't want to see that weight anymore. And I'm a very small woman, 5'3" tall. And that's a lot of weight for a woman that small. And I have a small bone structure. I just have long arms and legs. I don't know how God created me that way, but I have long arms and legs, long fingers. Like if you see my fingers are long. So it's just too much weight for me to have. And I know that at that time, a 217 pounds, I was in probably a very tight 16, probably 18 at that time. And I continued to creep up because I know that I was wearing a size 20 pair of clothes before I finally, you know, just kind of said, okay, it's time to do something different here. And I know that my body was probably close to 230. It might have even been over 230, but I did not get on the scale to check that out because I couldn't handle it emotionally. So since that time, of course, I'm no longer in the 200s. My body weight hovers between 175 and 185. That's where I hover. And that's still too much weight for my body. Most people, whenever they see me in real life, sometimes they don't think that I still weigh that much, but I do. But it's not really what people think. It's what is actually the reality. I still have too much weight on my body. And it's time to get rid of it. It's time to get rid of it. And the reason I'm sharing is because I want to document this journey on my YouTube channel as I lose the rest of my weight. Now, the weight that I'm supposed to weigh according to the right scales, okay? Not the scales that we have or the charts that we have based on what the average American does, okay? I'm talking about the healthy scales, the chart. I keep saying scale, but it's the chart that looks at health, not whether or not you need to have some extra meat on your body because you want to have curves, because there's a problem with that in itself too, because we want to have these curves at the expense of actually being sick in our body. So the scale or chart that I use was written by Dr. Joel Fuhrman, which you guys, if you've been watching me for any length of time, know that I love his work. That chart says that I'm supposed to weigh probably around 116 pounds, and I'm far away from that. But I believe that that's where I'm supposed to go, because I had a chat with him a long time ago, years ago, and part of that chat was about where I was supposed to be on that chart or scale. And it's 116 pounds. Now, would I like to, you know, like wave my magic wand? Here's my magic wand, and you know, I'd be at 116 pounds, and I never have to do any work to get there. Yes, I would like that to be the case, but that is not the case. So as you guys know, I eat very, very healthy. I eat healthy foods according to the way I teach you all how to heal naturally from reproductive issues. But how many of you know that you can actually manipulate healthy food and eat too much healthy food and cause you to either stay stagnant or gain weight? And that is what I believe I have been doing over the years. And here's why I believe it's the case. And the reason, first of all, before I tell you that, I want to say the reason I'm even coming here this morning is because it's been on my mind since yesterday, last night, actually. I'm like, God, are you saying that I'm supposed to document this process on my YouTube channel? Or is that what you're actually telling me that I'm supposed to be doing here? And it, like, I thought that like a few hours before I went to bed. I woke up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. It was on my mind. I woke up this morning, like closer to the time that I was supposed to wake up to go to the bathroom. It was on my mind. And when I finally woke up this morning, it was on my mind. So I was like, okay, I'll be obedient. I want to do what you want me to do, God. And so what that has led me to believe then is that I'm not the only person in this situation. So this is going to be a series of videos. So I'm going to document this process, and I'm going to show you what I learned as I walk through the process. Okay. Our mental state can dictate what the body does. So I have been through a lot of traumas in my life that have led to keeping weight on my body. So you could read into that and think whatever you want about that. You probably can come with some pretty close ideas as to what I'm talking about, and I'm not going to go into that stuff right now. But God has been so faithful. He has healed me from like all of it. So I'm not carrying around any of that baggage. So why am I holding on to the weight? So I think what has to happen sometimes is we have to make a decision that we are going to allow ourselves to get rid of the excess baggage in our lives. And in this particular case, the excess baggage that I have is the extra weight that I have in my body. So I don't know exactly what I weigh. Let's just say I weigh 185. So I'm subtract 185, 116. So that's like 70 pounds that I need to lose. So let's just look there. I will officially weigh myself and share that with you all next week about what my actual weight is and then how much I need to lose. But what I want to say here is that I have made a decision that I am going to allow myself to lose this excess weight that I have in my body. I'm giving my body permission to release the weight. So I'm publicly declaring that, sharing that with you. I am allowing myself to lose this weight. Now that I have said this, I know that there is some work that I need to do internally in my mindset and in my heart to go along with that declaration. And I am willing to do that at this moment. So I'll be working on that, and I will do the best that I can to share that with you as I walk through that journey. There are probably some of you who need to lose weight that you think you don't need to lose weight, and it's probably contributing to how terrible you feel. I don't feel like I used to feel because I don't eat the way I used to eat. But what I do need to do is tighten up my diet, eat the amount of calories that I need to eat for my particular frame to lose the weight that I need to lose. and I probably need to step up my exercise. I am a person that exercises. Like, I have been that way for a long time. I love exercising, but there's some things that I can do differently to help me on that journey. Some commitment issues, whatever, to the consistency that I need for my particular body type. And so that's really all I wanted to share with you today, that I was going to be documenting my weight loss journey. And the food that I eat is going to be basically the same. It's just the quantities are probably going to be different, and I need to figure that out. And I will share that with you in the next video. So the next video, I'll be sharing with you my weight. Let me just write myself a note so I see weight, caloric intake, and my exercise regimen, and anything else that God puts on my heart to share with you. The other thing I want to say too is about calories. So I'm not one that you need to count calories. Like, I think you should just eat if you're hungry, and if you're not, don't eat. That's technically what I think you should do. And at least that's what I tell my clients to do, and it typically works out well for them. But sometimes we think we're hungry and we're not really hungry. What we are is emotionally hungry. Like, we need God to come in and fill a place in our hearts where we're hurting or bored or tired. And what we tend to do is to go after food instead of ourselves filled up by what God has for us. And I think that even though I don't do it the way I used to do it when I was over 220 pounds, I still do it. So yeah, I just want to share that with you. And I'm going to stop doing that. I'm going to, you know, let God come on in and deal with the issues of my heart, so that I stop doing that. Run to Him instead of food. Run to Him instead of whatever. I mean, if you're a Netflix watcher, I don't watch Netflix, but whatever it is, those stupid little games on your phone, TV, relationships, sex, drugs, whatever. So I just wanted to share that with you. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend. Also, if you're on this journey, like in the place that I'm in, share your journey with me. I'd love for you to walk this road with me. I'd love to walk this road with you as I move through the letting go of holding on to excess weight for whatever reason. So, all right, ladies, lots of love, and I will talk to you all soon. Take care.